I'm going to describe the Euler method, which is a technique that is used to solve ordinary differential equations. Now, it's not a technique that in general you would use for accurate solutions. There are certainly better methods, but it's the simplest method, so it's useful for helping understanding how these numerical methods work. And so what we want to look at is we're going to solve an ordinary differential equation. The derivative of y respect to x is some function of x and y. We're going to have some initial conditions. Namely, we know at x equals some value x0, we know the value of y0. The particular example that we're going to use to demonstrate the actual numbers is just the differential equation where the function is 3 times x squared times y. And its initial conditions are going to be that when x equals 1, y equals 2. So the way we're going to solve the equation is to use a recurrence formula. And the one for the Euler method says the value of y at some point we'll call n plus 1 is the value y evaluated in plus some difference between the x values, x evaluated n plus 1 minus x evaluated n, times our function, the right side of the differential equation, evaluated at x in and y in. And so this is known. This is why we need initial conditions somewhere to start. This is what we refer to as the step size. And we know, for example, beginning, we know y at x equals x0. So we're going to take a small step away from x and then calculate the new value of y. And this, of course, is the right side of our differential equation. And notice it's calculated at the point that we know the values of x in and y in. We also can write as y in times the step size h, which here we'll keep constant in the Euler method, typically is kept constant, times the function evaluated x in, y in. So this is the step size. The smaller the step size, the more accurate the Euler method. So let's look at graphically what we're doing in the Euler method. So I'm looking at some generic function, and I want to calculate starting at a value that I know. So assume we know the value here. This could be our x0, y0. The derivative of y respect to x is the slope of this curve at any point. That's the function of x and y at that point. And so the slope corresponds to a tangent at this point. So let's look at a blow up of just this region. Let's assume this is magnified 50 times. Take a small step in the x direction. And of course, y changes by a small amount. And what we're doing is assuming delta y over delta x, that's equal to that function evaluated at this point, in this case, x0, y0. And of course, that's true at any point as we step through. This delta x value is what we're going to call h, our step size. And so we're approximating, we're saying this point on this tangent line is quite close to the actual value on the blue curve. So let's look at some numbers to see how this would work for our example. And so I'm going to use to illustrate the approach a value of h of 0.1. Certainly probably too big to be very accurate, but just to demonstrate the idea, as I use smaller numbers, it's going to be more accurate. Let's look at then our first point, x1, which is x0 plus h, so it's 1.1, and then we can calculate y1, which is y0 plus h times the function evaluate, and this is important, at x0 and y0, because we know x0 and y0. And of course, we're given y0. We picked a step size of 0.1. Now we can evaluate this function, which is 3 times x0. x0 in this case is 1 squared. y0 is 2. And so this gives us a value for y1. It says y1 is 2.6. And so we can now calculate the next step, namely x2, which is x1 plus 0.1. So x2 is 1.2. y2, y1 plus h times the function. Now evaluated x1 and y1. And again, if I substitute in the numbers, then I'll calculate a value of y2, 3.5438. So I can continue to step through. Let's just look at one more. So now I've calculated y3, and then the Euler method, which of course doing on computer goes much faster. This at x4, we can calculate y4. And continue to move through. If I used a smaller value of step size instead of 0.1, I'll get a more accurate approximation to the solution of this differential equation. But the idea here is to show the general procedure, and then more complicated recurrence formulas are used in some of the other techniques like the Runge-Kutta method for solving ordinary differential equations.